Good afternoon, everyone. We're interrupting regularly scheduled programming to bring you the latest on Hurricane Iselle, as well as Tropical Storm Julio. Now, all Hawaiian islands are under a flash flood watch beginning 4 a.m. tomorrow, and the Big Island is currently under a tropical storm warning right now. Let's take a look at that track to see where the storm is going. It's still moving to the west, and notice as it starts to approach the Big Island, it's going from a hurricane into a tropical storm. That small circle you see near the icon, that is 8 a.m. Thursday and 69 miles per hour, that small circle is the radius of tropical storm force winds that the islands could see. So we'll advance it to the next time frame, and you could see that the Big Island is clearly going to see most of that tropical storm force winds, maybe a little bit of Maui County, but all islands are in for some possibly heavy drenching rain and gusty winds. The storm will then impact the rest of the island chain after moving over the Big Island on Friday and then moving out of the vicinity late Friday evening into Saturday. As far as the track, there's fairly high confidence in the track. As you can see, the various computer forecast models are fairly clustered together, and all of them have the storm system moving over the Big Island again late Thursday afternoon and through the rest of the island chain on Friday. So there's quite high confidence that this storm will be on the track that is forecast, and all islands are under that cone of uncertainty. As far as a storm right behind tropical or hurricane Iselle, we have Julio. Now, Julio is expected to be a Category 1 hurricane over the next several days, but it also is expected to weaken into a tropical storm as it nears the state. Now, the difference in track between Julio and Iselle is Julio's track seems to have it moving a little bit more north of the islands. Again, this is too far out to know for sure, but Julio could impact the islands again with strong winds as well as heavy rains. And we're talking about the Sunday into Monday time frame. Again, this forecast track for Julio is farther to the north. However, as you can see, all islands are still in that cone of uncertainty. So here's what we can expect from Iselle. Arriving as a tropical storm with a direct hit near or very over the Big Island. Let's go to National Weather Service right now with the latest.
Welcome to the 2 p.m. briefing on Hurricane Iselle, who's expected to affect and impact the main Hawaiian islands later this week. I'll go right into the briefing, and we'll take any questions right at the end. So Hurricane Iselle, it's currently about 1,000 miles away from the main Hawaiian Islands, and it's moving towards the Hawaii at about 13 miles per hour. It has weakened a bit since the overnight hours, and it's sped up in speed over the last 24. So right now it's moving at 13 miles per hour, and we're expecting this to continue on its path towards the Hawaiian Islands.
Sorry to interrupt. Can you up the volume a little bit more for those on teleconference?
Should put the phone up. Is this better?
A little bit.
Okay, I'll talk louder. Yeah. So let's move on, Jordan. Iselle is speeding up. It's continuing its westward track towards the main Hawaiian Islands within the trade wind flow. I'm expected to stick around as a hurricane through Wednesday. And it's expected to continue to weaken as it approaches the main Hawaiian Islands to a tropical storm. Excellent. CPHC, Central Pacific Hurricane Center, has taken over the forecast responsibility since 11 a.m. It's taken over the responsibility from the National Hurricane Center in Miami. So as we said earlier...
Is it possible to hear?
Okay. Hurricane Iselle is forecast to weaken through... They're not able to hear. So Hurricane Iselle is expected to continue weakening through Wednesday, but remaining a hurricane. It's expected to weaken because it's moving into cooler waters, and we're expecting increased wind shear also to rip the system apart as it approaches the islands. So as a tropical storm, it's going to impact the main Hawaiian islands beginning Thursday afternoon on the Big Island and then moving up the island chain as we move into Friday. So Iselle is forecast to impact the Big Island as a tropical storm Thursday afternoon, and then it's going to be moving across Maui County on Thursday evening and into Oahu Thursday night and Friday morning. And then Kauai is expected to experience the tropical storm conditions on Friday. There is a threat for flash flooding and coastal inundations over the main Hawaiian islands Thursday afternoon through Friday. Also with tropical storm force winds of about 45 to 55 miles per hour with gusts to 65. So we need to stay updated on the latest forecast and pay attention to your local media. Let's move on. So this is the situation right now. We have a flash flood watch in effect for the main Hawaiian islands. Tropical storm watch is currently in effect for the Big Island and its surrounding coastal waters. Potential impacts from Tropical Storm Julio we're looking at later on this weekend. After Iselle passes through the main Hawaiian islands, Julio is expected to take a path similar to Iselle, but it is currently more than 5 days away, and we are currently watching that situation, and we'll be providing any updates as Julio gets closer to the main Hawaiian islands. So that kind of wraps things up, kind of a very quick overview of our current situation, and if there's any questions, I can take that right now.
Has the path changed at all in the last 24 hours from what you guys were predicting?
The path has shifted a little bit to the south. So it is. It continues to make its way towards the Hawaiian Islands, but it is a little bit further south than what it was last night.
What kind of winds are we expecting? How fast?
We're expecting winds of 45 to 55 miles per hour, gusts to 65 miles per hour. There could be locally stronger winds, especially around ridges and exposed valleys.
Eric, you talked about running over some cooler waters. There was some discussion about, I guess, a slug of warmer water a little bit closer to the islands. Are we still expecting that?
There is a little bit of warmer water ahead of the Big Island. However, the storm itself, moving at 13 miles per hour, isn't going to have enough time to sit over that warm water to intensify further. So we are continuing to expect a decrease in intensity for the system.
Eric, have you guys been in contact with the DOE? And from what we know right now, I mean, would it be maybe your recommendation, or what would be your recommendation for as far as schools on Thursday and Friday?
I cannot make any recommendations to the DOE, but the DOE has to take a look at their operations plans to see how they need to determine what they need to do with their system.
I mean, if we're talking 45 and 55 mile an hour gusts, and we're talking schools in session and getting to and from school, I mean, I don't know, just, and obviously you're not a principal or DOE administrator, but just from a meteorologist standpoint, I mean,
right. With winds like that, there could be a lot of blown trees, falling limbs, and potential power outages as well. So everyone needs to take into consideration these impacts that could be affecting the school system, just to keep everyone safe.
You talked a little bit about flooding concerns. How much can we expect from this particular system, and what areas are you most worried about?
Right now, we're looking at 5 to 8 inches of rain statewide. There could be localized areas within the windward side who could get a little bit more. And that poses a major threat for flash flooding across the state. And, you know, people in low-lying areas should be very wary of the conditions.
With the track of this storm, where it is, if it were to keep going on this particular track, the windward areas, you are used to seeing a little bit more rain than some of the leeward spots, but that 5 to 8, you're talking about even in some leeward areas as well?
Correct, yes.
So it could be some areas that aren't used to getting 5 to 8 inches.
Right, right.
Any advice for people who do live right on the coastline there that are going to be hit directly?
They should follow emergency managers' recommendations if they feel that people need to evacuate, then they should heed that warning.
Is Julio expected to drop that much rain as well?
It's a little too far out to tell right now. It is. It's going to take a path similar to Iselle. It's currently more than 5 days out, so you know it's still really out of our forecast knowledge for that system.
Is it getting stronger as it comes, or is it kind of losing strength as well?
Julio is currently a tropical storm. It is expected to gain strength into a Category 1 hurricane within the next 24 to 48 hours. And right now, the forecast path has it towards the main Hawaiian Islands within the next 5 days. Yep.
The forecast track has shifted over the past few days, shifted a little to the north, shifted a little bit to the south. What is going to, over the next 2 days before this arrives, what could change this or wouldn't change it?
Yeah,
why is it going to stay the same?
Forecasting tropical cyclones is difficult, especially 5 days out. So we need to pay attention to, you know, the environmental conditions surrounding the system to actually know what's going to go on. So things could change. And
with Iselle, not as much as with Julio, but with
Iselle.
Iselle, over the next 2 days, what are you looking at that may change, that may adjust the forecast?
We're pretty confident in the forecast track, although there's going to be some minor jogs in it. We're not expecting it to deviate greatly from what we're forecasting right now. So we just need to be aware of the situation.
So pretty confident that it is going to hit the islands. It's just a matter of where and how strong.
Right.
Are there going to be differences for Iselle between the Big Island, Maui, and Oahu and Kauai, just the various islands?
Yeah, it's going to depend totally on the terrain and the mountainous regions of each island. Some places that are more favorable for heavier rain, you know, where winds are perpendicular to the mountains, they could get higher rainfall. You know, we're looking at stuff like that. So there are some places that could get localized more rain in areas.
Any other storm systems behind these that you guys are looking at or anything developing?
Not right now. We're currently just looking at Iselle and Julio.
How uncommon is it for Hawaii to have a 1-2 punch like this? I mean, some people are looking at it that way, that we're getting walloped twice within a matter of a week or so.
Right. It is rare. Not to say that it could never happen. But just the conditions as we kind of develop more into the El Nino situation, with warmer sea surface temperatures, it just provides a more favorable environment for the development of tropical cyclones and increased tropical cyclone activity.
So why is it so rare? There's a number of systems each year. Is it because Hawaii is so small on the map?
Hawaii is a small target in the big ocean, so it just has to be really good timing, and the conditions have to be just right for us to get a direct hit. And we've been lucky so far, so we just need to, you know, really take this threat seriously and make sure everybody is prepared for whatever conditions it brings us.
Are there any impacts or effects between the two storms? Do they affect each other at all?
Not so much.
Completely separate?
Yeah. There shouldn't be direct impacts with two storms together, yeah. So with that, if there are no more questions, I'll conclude this press conference.
Hi, Eric, actually tied on the telephone conference, so I could hardly barely hear you, but can you run through a little bit of calling from Maui? Can you tell me again what the path is for Iselle for Maui County and what kinds of effects you could see?
Sure. For Maui County, we are looking at impacts affecting your area Thursday evening. And for Maui County, we could be looking at winds 45 to 55 miles per hour and rainfall within 5 to 8 inches, with some areas a little bit more.
Thank you.
Sure.
All right, once again, that was Eric Lau from the Central Pacific Hurricane Center. Wrapping up, Hurricane Iselle arriving as a tropical storm, a direct hit or very near the islands, most likely and high chance of it actually going right over the Big Island. Thursday afternoon and Friday, we're talking about 5 to 8 inches of rain. Some spots, especially near the mountains, might see more rain, and winds 45 to 55 miles per hour, gusting to 65 miles per hour. Now, we'll keep you up to date online on our Facebook, Twitter accounts, also on the web, and our newscast coming up next at the 5, 6, and 10, also on Wake Up Today, and just about every newscast will have an update until both of these storm systems are clear of the islands.